everyone, and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. For today's video, guys, I got a 6-inch carbon pipe. I'm just gonna show you things to avoid when you're doing TIG root. As you can see here, I got a 4 mm on the bottom and 3 mm up on the top gap. It's a little bit uneven, but it doesn't matter as long as I got bigger gap on the bottom. That's what I like, so I can put good, nice, solid root. Okay, so the first thing, what might go wrong when you're doing TIG root, if you got issues on the bottom, it can be your tungsten stick out, the condition of your tungsten, the way or the angle or inclination when you're doing actually root. If you're going too much and pausing on the side, it might create internal undercuts. You don't want to burn too much on walls. It's just gonna create open even a bigger gap, and it's gonna be difficult for you to fill all that hole, especially at the bottom part. Depends from the inclination, how you feed that rod. That's really important. That's something you have to find out what's work for you the best. 90 degree back feed, or you want to go under the angle. The other thing too, once you're in position, you start welding, and then I forgot to turn on the argon. And if you got tungsten like this, definitely want to change it. You don't want to continue welding with this. This is maybe good for aluminum, but it's different settings. So with the tungsten, is really important the size of your tungsten and the amperage. If you got for example 1/8 tungsten and 80 amps 70 amps, it's just gonna give you unstable arc, and it's gonna be impossible to weld. It's too cold, you're going too slow, you're not burning that rod. It's just gonna leave you cold wire, leave you stubs inside the root. And as you can see here, example, you're going too much on the side, pausing, delaying in adding that wire, going too much forward, opening that root even more, and then just burn that wire. And it's that's thing you want to avoid, definitely. As I said, as you can see, the arc is really unstable, as it's probably low amperage for this size of a tungsten. And then on the end, you got tungsten inclusion as well. I hope you're not going to continue welding with that tungsten. Just going to show you a little bit more examples for freehand. Example here, you know, you are an unstable arm, you're too shaky, and then you're pausing, delays with adding that wire. You're way ahead of that puddle, burn that rod, and it's just no good. Definitely no good. That's things we want to avoid. And this is the result for the root. It looks like sugaring on your a stainless, but this is actually a carbon. As you can see, there's lots of welding issues here. Cold wire, internal undercut, probably porosity, tungsten inclusion, and etc. and so on and so on. So the first thing we have to do, sharp your tungsten. If you got 2% aerated or any tungsten, sharp bowed ends. Size of your cup plays a really big role. The stick out, the other thing, I always go 9 to 10 mm. It all depends from the depth of my bevel. Like this is like 9 mm, and I like to check. This is for the reference. If it's touching the edge of the bevel, this is pretty much my stakeout. So the amperage, I'll go with 130 for root, with 1/8 wire. Feather edge, both sides. I always do with a feather edge. Prep, clean, in and out. This is the things you have to really pay attention to. And so when you're doing root, don't focus too much on the wall. Aim your tungsten in the puddle and stretch that puddle. Generally, yes, you are aiming in the middle. And you are aiming in the middle of that puddle, but angles and inclination always changes as you're progressing up. It always changes a little bit, you know, you gotta reposition yourself or whatever, but you see, you focus on the puddle and you stretch that puddle. Side to side motion, and the amperage, and will do the rest. You'll push that rod inside, and you're gonna have burned edges and this is the result you're gonna get. You're gonna have nice solid root, especially at the bottom. This is the good start for any welder, and then you just continue on following the same thickness. Or it doesn't have to be perfect, it doesn't have to be perfect ring root all the way around. It just gotta be a nice healthy root, solid, so you can pass an x-ray. Same thing when you continue on your stop starts. I always like to grind and then just add that wire, keep it connected, and stretch that puddle. See, you're actually stretching puddle. You don't post too much on the sides, on the wall. You don't want to open that. You're just stretching. If you lose connection once in a while, you just reconnect. No panic, no rush, and just focus on that puddle. So you aiming in the middle and stretching left, right, side to side motion, and just keep it connected. The puddle will form nice good root inside. You just gotta stretch that puddle and everything else will be done for you. So the edges are opening anyway. It's like a fillet wire or technique. Now we're on the top part, and as you know, the gravity will do the rest, so no worries. So you don't have to keep it deep inside. You can always pull that rod out a little bit and the gravity will do the rest. As I said, and this is the result you're gonna get. Just keep that things in mind, you know, your argon. I always go with 15 to 25, 30 liters per minute CPH for your TIG torch. Sharp tungsten, cup size, inclination, the way how you feed. There's a few things, you know, you have to pay attention to, you know, you have to dial in with all that stuff. Once you do, it'll be good, it'll be easy. And as always, bottom part is most important. That's in my opinion. I think the bottom, lots of people got issue at the bottom. I did as well when I started up back in the days. Always too much worried about the bottom. You don't want to have any issues, especially if it's like really flash with the surface. Then you're scared for a sack back. That's why I like nice, good, solid root at the bottom, and then just continue on. As you can see here, guys, just focus on that puddle, aim that tungsten in the middle, and stretch side to side. The edges are opening anyway, as you can see, so you don't have to like go ahead, rush, and then burn the edges, and then add the rod. Then you're just gonna create more mess, so, and internal undercuts. And that's it, pretty much. That's it for the root. Once you got nice solid root inside, that's good. As I said, bottom is most important. Everything else is have the things to pay attention to, guys. Once again, the size of your gap, tungsten. So don't go too much on the sides. You know, don't rush before that puddle or before that rod to open that side. When you dip tungsten, change it. You don't want to weld with that kind of tungsten. This is what we want to avoid. You don't want that. Definitely, that's a cutout. It's gonna fail. Not only X-ray, it's gonna fail visual and everything. Always keep sharp tungsten, cup size, amperage, stick out. That's the thing. That's the starting point, and the amperage. Play a little bit with amps. You know, from 95. Even if you go less than 100, then change the probably size of your tungsten. Probably T32. And okay, that's it for today's video, guys. See you in the next one. Hope you like it. Bye.